decommissioned bridge simulator can give an idea of what could happen if a ship were to face inclement weather.
There's land over there, correct. And there's land over there, even though you can't see it.
I've got the controls at the bridge of our cargo vessel, caught in a virtual storm at sea.
Probably what you want to start to do at this point in time is start to talk to your crew about preparing to abandon ship.
As I try to heave to, a tactic I need power to perform, we're hit by a wave and capsize.
It's that quick when a wave hits you like that.
It's that quick.
Bob Russo owns Maritime License Training Company in Jacksonville. Although this is a simulated storm, it's not simulated to be a hurricane.
Nobody's trying to sail through a hurricane. You're trying to come avoid up it. With a plan to
yep.
avoid it.
Yep.
To find out what happened to our boat, we need to find the Voyage data recorder. The VDR activates when wet and sends out pings via a sonar.
It's going to have the radar on it to start with.
Okay.
All right. It's going to have charting information, including position and other data.
Telling us where
the boat is. Yeah, where we were at a series of points in time.
A basic VDR can ping for up to 30 days. That is, if it's fully charged.
If we lost power at some point, is that going to affect
everything?
The lifespan of this?
Sure. I mean, the way the systems work, basically, we have so much life. In a system.
But it will have stored
it will have stored it had before, yes.
Also on board, these beacons called EPIRBs, which detach and send distress signals to satellites. In the case of the El Faro, 2 days into their investigation, NTSB officials were not aware of any pings or signals going out.
This should have floated free on the ship.
Where is that? Where
we don't know. We don't know. It could have been trapped when the ship possibly rolled over. We don't know.
If the El Faro's Voyage data recorder were to be recovered, it could hold up to 12 hours of information. Whether that would tell us how the ship sank, we just don't know. In Jacksonville, I'm Katie Thompson, WMTW News 8.